So, Kron in Rawhide. Let's see what I got here. Clear. So to make this work, at least let me just first show you what I changed, and it's not complete just to get this unconfined stuff to work, but hopefully you'll get the point. Anyway, so I created a module. I needed to create a module here with some extra modification for this stuff. So basically I just expanded the cron user domain boolean a little bit to allow unconfined cron job t to entry point the user cron pool t, because in reference policy unconfined domains can actually can actually entry point of all files by default. As you can see here, allow files unconfined type, file type, and then file and character file, everything except exact mode. Whereas in Fedora, it has the entry point here as well. So that means that unconfined domains cannot automatically entry point of all file type. So you get into all kinds of issues. For example, simply running, if for example in my test I wanted to create a cron job that basically run the id -z command to basically echo the context to a file, so it needed to run a shell as unconfined cron job t, which is an unconfined domain, but it wasn't allowed to entry point to the shell on the shell exec file, so that failed. So yeah, I'm not sure why Fedora added this entry point here. In ref policy we don't have that, but anyways, this is actually what's causing one problem, where as unconfined cron job t cannot entry point, or user cron spool t cannot, is not an entry point to the unconfined cron job t type. So that's a problem there that I had to fix, and that's what I basically did here. I basically expanded. This is actually a Fedora specific module. In ref policy this is not needed, but it's for Fedora, so that basically if the boolean is set to on, then allow unconfined cron job t the entry point on user cron spool t, and else don't out it, don't allow it. This is the policy change, and then there's some other changes that I had to make, and this is kind of weird. CD etc SE Linux targeted contexts users, and let's just less unconfined you. Now the weird thing is that, so basically I added the on top of here, and let's just nano it so that I can go there and show you that. So basically here the top line, I added this unconfined r unconfined cron job t, and basically I put it in front of the unconfined r and unconfined t. For some reason it doesn't work the other way around, and that's something I can't really explain, because it doesn't make sense. But anyways, I fiddled around a little bit, and it seems that this actually does work, so we'll just test that out again. But I tested it and it seems to actually work. But the point is that you need to actually also add this one here, because cron will check and see whether it's authorized to use the context, and by adding it there it's allowed. But you need to do this also for your confined domains, of course. You need to do both cron job and the confined context there. And then finally, not sure if it's actually needed, but I also edited this nano default context, to basically allow unconfined r unconfined cron job t there, and you should probably also do that for all the other cron domains, like for example staff R and then cron job T and stuff like that. Not sure if it's actually needed, but I just did that to stay in sync with ref policy, because I know in ref policy it works. So I just basically try to make it look the same. So currently, let's just test it out. So currently I have get a C bool, a grab cron. It's set to on, so it supposedly should transition. Now let's just add a cron tab, or I just added it. I have 12:09, I guess. Oh, actually too late. I'm not sure if it actually... might have been just in time, and actually was in time. And get in force, it's enforcing. So basically it's written the IDC command to temp test, so cut temp test text, and you'll see that the file is created with the expected context. So let's just toggle it to off the boolean. Where is it? Somewhere in my history. Off. And now just add one again. For 10, hopefully. And then just have a look and see what's going to happen. And now we have the permission denied here. And this is actually the entry point issue that I was talking about. See, but the transition actually happened, so you don't have to actually worry about that, because the fact that it's permission denied just shows you that it happened. But I can show you that if I do out search. Out search, where are you? For 12:10, or yeah, 12:10. And you see that it's the entry point issue here, but you can also see that the cron job ran in the expected domain, unconfined cron job T. So yeah, the fact is that in Fedora we actually removed the entry point permission for unconfined domains on files. So that sucks, kind of. But there must be a good reason for Dan or for you to have done that, I guess. But in ref policy that's not the case. So in ref policy just works. So that's basically the whole thing. You need to take care of your default context. And with regards to the default context, there's this weird thing that, and I'll show you that once more, that you actually need to make look at the ordering. That you actually need to make sure that you have the unconfined cron job first, and then the unconfined T context, because if you do it the other way around, then it still keeps barking about an authorized context. Don't ask me why, because maybe that's actually a bug in the function that's being called here or whatever. But basically you're saying here both of these contexts are authorized, so if the first one fails, then just try the next one, and if the next one succeeds, then go with the next one. But for some reason it doesn't work if you start with unconfined T and then the second context unconfined cron job T. So that's basically it, and it seems to work pretty consistently. So I'll just